Today, I'm talking to two key executives from Etiqa to get their perspective on mental health in Malaysia. And I'm talking to both Encik Zafri Abdul Halim, CEO of Etiqa Family Takaful Berhad, and Paul Low, CEO of Etiqa Life Insurance Berhad. Welcome, Encik Zafri. How are you today?
Thank you, Azlan. I'm good. Thank you.
Wonderful. So can you give us a short description about what you see are the critical challenges for Etiqa in the context of health and mental health, and especially in the context of Islamic finance?
Among the challenges faced by Etiqa Family Takaful, I would like to highlight three things. One is on the medical inflation. Medical costs are increasing on average 13% year on year. And as a result, contribution for medical takaful coverage in the country have been increasing at an unsustainable rate in recent years. Number two, many customers want their health insurance to connect with them on a personal level. Many want their insurer to be a trusted advisor, like advisor that can educate but not overwhelm them with the information and choices. And on the last one, on mental health require long-term care.
Indeed. And already before COVID hit Malaysia, you've taken that leadership position and included mental illnesses into your critical illnesses list. What made you do that?
Because actually we saw the growing need to provide coverage for mental illness due to the increasing trend in the numbers of Malaysians suffering from mental health problems. At the time that we launched our Afia Care, we were well aware that staggering 29.2% of Malaysians were suffering from mental illness.
Are there other data points that you can share to highlight or describe the extent of this issue in Malaysia today?
We can see both actually, or at the global level and also in Malaysia. According to World Health Organization, one in four individuals develop a common mental disorder, such as depression or anxiety every year, with two in every 100 people developing manic depression in their lifetime. And in Malaysia, the Malaysian Ministry of Health expected mental health disorder to be the second highest form of health problem affecting Malaysia after heart diseases. What I find devastating about mental illness is that many suffer in silence. Mental illness is a subject that has traditionally been something difficult to talk about. There be maybe stigma associated with the condition and a lack of understanding. However, it is seem to be slowly changing as this topic been more widely spoken about, and there are more and more avenue for people to seek help.
What about your particular focus on mental issues from an Islamic viewpoint?
If we are looking at the principle of Sharia or Makasid al-Sharia, among the key objectives of Sharia are to protect the life, or they call it al-naf, and also to protect the intellect, al-aqal, of a person. So a sound intellect contributes to a sound life. In other words, affected mental health will lead to an affected sound mind, which generally leads to poor decision making. So based on this, we can appreciate how Islamic law protects the sanctity of intellect and life. The promotion of a person's well-being, including the person's mental health, is of utmost priority, where mental health is part of the necessity, or daruriyat they call it, of the human being, and utmost priority must be given to protect the mental health of a person.
Okay, fantastic. Well, Encik Zafri, thank you very much for sharing with us what Etiqa Family Takaful is doing in this field, recognizing that this is a serious issue. So between 1 in 4 or 30% of Malaysians are wrestling with this, but many are suffering from silence. Thank you very much for sharing, Encik Zafri. Well, welcome, Paul. can you share some data on mental health issues, the prevalence here in Malaysia, and how has that been growing over time?
One thing, especially during this pandemic COVID time, the awareness of mental health in Malaysia actually is not that high. Actually, the penetration rate of the life insurance, health insurance in Malaysia is only about 54%.
Okay.
So there are still a lot of people are not insured under the insurance scheme. Since pandemic began last year, the government agency has received a lot of calls to inquire about the health issues. And 85.5% of the calls, when they call in, they are basically, they inquire about mental issues.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And a lot of them, they need so-called psychological support and emotional support and counseling. So yeah, that is quite bad in a way. And the cases are increasing, and psychologically, they need some help. Okay, and with the prolonging of this pandemic, I will foresee that the mental health issue will continue to rise.
What are some of the challenges of Malaysian urbanites with respect to their mental health?
You ask the right question. Okay, most of us, we live in the big city. And, living in a big city, we face some challenges. Okay, the living cost is higher.
Mm-hmm.
And congestion, we need to fight the traffic, And also, in terms of so-called socialization, socializing, some of us, we being isolated from our community. So that poses a challenge, for those who live in the big city like KL.
And what about with the pandemic, right? With COVID-19, certainly in the last 12 to 18 months, what do you think accelerates the issues of mental health for Malaysians?
Yeah, this is very unfortunate because of the lockdown. Okay, and I understand why the lockdown is because of the curb the spread of the COVID-19. And with this lockdown, actually it had created disruption in terms of in the society, and also in terms of economy. And with all this lockdown, some businesses they have forced to close down, and some workers are being let go, and some of their salaries being reduced like up to like 50%. That has added a lot of stress in the family.
Do you have any tips for Malaysians? How do we deal with mental health issues? How do we prevent ourselves from becoming mentally ill?
I think if a person feels that he has suffered from certain type of anxiety or distress, I think he or she may want to find a person who they can trust to really share that feeling, and also seek professional help before it's too late. Okay, and mental illness is kind of related to a person's physical well-being. So if a person can exercise regularly and eat well and sleep well, I think that will help to prevent mental illness from deteriorating.
What about any new developments or products on the horizon with regards to mental health? What else is on the Etika agenda going forward?
Yeah, mental health is one of the social issues. So in line with our push for ESG, so we are paying a lot of attention to this area, ESG, for us to develop new products. So we want to cover every family, we want to provide that kind of protection for the society. So that's always on our radar to really come up with products to cater to our Malaysians' needs.
Fantastic. Thank you very much, Paul, for sharing with us and the audience your outlook on building positive mental health and resilience for Malaysians going forward. Thank you.
Thank you, Ashwin.